Here's yet another example. This is actually a special case of the previous example where we took a degree D polynomial. Now let's look at the special case where the value of D is equal to 0. In other words, this polynomial just reduces to a constant value. Let's call that constant value as just A. So what if T of n is equal to some constant A? Well, we can claim that in this case, T of n is theta of n to the power of 0. Right? We can arrive at this by just replacing d by 0. So if we have a degree 0 polynomial, it's going to be theta of n to the power of 0. So how do we prove this? Well, one way to prove it is by just implying as a corollary from the previous example that if this holds for all d greater than or equal to 0, then it definitely holds for d equal to 0, the special case of d equal to 0. And so we can directly prove that. But you know, if you want to prove this from scratch, you can again use the definition of the theta notation to argue that T of n is theta of n to the power 0 here because there exist constants c1 and c2, positive constants c1 and c2, such that A or T of n can be sandwiched between two constant multiples of n to the power 0. Now n to the power 0 is of course 1. And so you want to prove that there exist constants c1 and c2 such that A is sandwiched between c1 and c2. Now that's trivial because if T of n is just a constant function like this, we can choose a value of c1 between A and 0. We can choose any value between A and 0 to be c1, and we can choose any value larger than A to be c2. And we're going to end up with two horizontal lines between which this horizontal line, Tn is equal to A, is sandwiched. Right, so this is the curve T of n, this is the curve c2 times n to the power 0, and this is the curve c1 times n to the power 0. So T of n can be sandwiched between two constant multiples of n to the power 0. For all n, this applies for all n greater than or equal to 0. So the threshold is 0 itself here, n naught is 0 itself. For any positive value of n, this is going to hold if we choose c1 to be some number between a and 0. Let's say we choose c1 to be a by 2. And we can choose c2 to be you know, either a plus 1 or let's say twice of a. So this proves that T of n is theta of n to the power 0 because we have satisfied the definition of theta notation here. We have determined values of these constants c1 and c2, and we have argued that there does exist a threshold beyond which T of n can be sandwiched between these two constant multiples of n to the power 0. Now instead of denoting theta of n to the power 0 as theta of n to the power 0, we are going to, this is more commonly denoted as theta of 1 because n to the power 0 is 1. So any constant